Greetings. This is video number 6 in a series comparing Christianity to Islam, and it is the third video examining the self-consistency within Islam and the Quran. What does Islam say about itself? We have already examined quite a few inconsistent foundational claims by Islam. The Quran is another revelation from the God of Abraham. Torah, Psalms, and Bible are the word of Allah. The word of its Allah cannot be changed. It respects and worships the God of Abraham. You must say Shahada to be Muslim. All prophets from Adam to Jesus were Muslim before Muhammad, and Islam claims Muhammad was foretold in the Torah and Injil. What additional claims does Islam make about itself? The following is a pair of related claims which Islam makes directly by the Quran. Islam claims that Allah sent prophets of Islam to every nation on earth in the past. Islam claims the message of Islam was sent to every nation on earth in the past. Where does Islam make these claims? Surah 35:24. Verily, we have sent you with the truth a bearer of glad tidings and a warner, and there never was a nation but a warner had passed among them. Surah 10:47. And for every ummah, community, or nation, there is a messenger. When their messenger comes, the matter will be judged between them with justice, and they will not be wronged. But this begs the question. If prophets were sent to every nation, why is there no historical record of any of them? The only prophets which Islam can name are Jewish prophets, and not one prophet of Islam. And another question begs to be asked. If scriptures were sent to every nation, why is there not one single shred of manuscript evidence to show this? And if ummahs or communities were started in every nation, why is there no record and no survivors, or any trace of Islam before Muhammad? The claim of Islam is that every nation, hundreds and thousands, have been sent warners and scriptures, presumably the same message as that of the Quran. Yet there is not one single manuscript and not one single ummah which has survived and grown and continued. In the final analysis, doesn't that mean that Allah has been a complete and utter failure to send a message and protect his message and preserve it? This is not consistent with the claim that Allah is all-knowing and all-powerful. Islam simply cannot answer this in a plausible and consistent way. Islam claims that Muhammad is the seal of the prophets, meaning the last prophet, ever. But Islam also claims the enlightened one, the Mahdi, will come in the last days. But that begs a question. If Muhammad is the seal of the prophets, the Mahdi cannot be a prophet. The Mahdi cannot be a messenger, or else he would be a prophet. If Mahdi is a prophet, Muhammad would not be the last prophet, would he? How then can the Mahdi be called enlightened? This is an inconsistency in Islamic claims. Islam claims there are no contradictions or errors in the Quran. But if you read the Quran and actually pay attention, there are many contradictions and errors in it. How can Islam explain this away? The Quran teaches a concept of abrogation and replacement. Newer surah that change the message and correct the message replace previous errant revelations. But that begs a question. If the Quran is Allah's perfect word, how and why did Allah make the mistake in the revelation to begin with? Why is there any need for Allah to correct and fix statements he allegedly made earlier in the revelation of the Quran? This is a very basic inconsistency in Islam's claims about itself and the Quran. Something perfect does not need updates. But that begs more questions. Why did Allah create the Quran with contradictions that needed abrogation? Islam claims the Quran is perfectly preserved from Allah's pen to what we now have. The stories and fables explaining how the Quran was created are as varied as they are fanciful. Take, for example, Islam's claim that Isaiah 29:12 is a perfect description of Muhammad. Isaiah 29:12 says, "And the book is delivered by an angel to him that is not learned, saying, Read this, I pray you, and he said, I am not learned." By claiming this verse is Muhammad, Islam claims the Quran was a completed book which an angel could hold in his hands and give physically to a man, Muhammad. But this begs the question, if the Quran was a completed book before Muhammad began his revelations, why did the angel begin reading with Surah 93:1? Why not start reading with the first word of the first page of the first surah? Why did the angel jump around at random and not read the book in any kind of order other than apparent convenient need? What does that mean? Muhammad would often receive a revelation that he needed at the moment to support his position and his power. Convenient indeed. For example, a Muslim may only have 4 wives, but when Muhammad wanted a 5th, he conveniently received a special news update for himself to have more. Very convenient indeed. So are the stories and accounts of how the Quran was created consistent with themselves? No. Islam's stories are not consistent and change and grow every time they are questioned. There are many, many questions about how the Quran was gathered over 23 years, and they all cast doubt on the reliability of the claims. Islam claims Muhammad is the Holy Spirit. Part of the effort to place Muhammad into the Gospel, the Bible, is to claim Muhammad is the Comforter, the Holy Spirit that Jesus foretold. But that begs many questions. Why does Islam appeal to the Book of John as the Injil, then deny that the Book of John is the Injil? This is a glaring inconsistency. So is Islam being consistent with itself? No, it is not. It tries to manufacture credentials for Muhammad from a book that Islam also calls corrupted. That is simply not consistent. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Clearly examining the self-inconsistency within the Quran and Islam could fill a library.